So, hello. Before I shall start with our firearms law, I will refer how Czech law treats weapons in general. Please excuse my English. I learned most of my English from books. I don't have much experience with speaking, so please be tolerant. About weapons in general. Our law divides weapons into two categories theoretically, but just one in practice. Shooting weapons are covered by Firearms Act. It doesn't mean just firearms, it also covers air guns, paintball guns, crossbows and similar things, pretty much anything that shoots. For other weapons, we have no laws at all. I don't know whether this liberal country exists anywhere in the world, but actually, if it doesn't shoot, there is no law for it. It counts just like item. The only definition of weapon which we have is in our penal law that states quite similar like in other countries, that weapon is anything that can make bodily assault more forceful. But unlike other countries, only actual criminal use is prohibited. You are forbidden to assault somebody, you are prohibited to threat somebody, you are prohibited to endanger somebody by negligence. Everything else is perfectly legal. On the other hand, when you actually do something criminal, our law is pretty strict. So you can go down the street with sword on your belt or dagger under your jacket, and you are perfectly legal. But if you bash somebody with something as ordinary as mug or chair or something, it does count as armed assault in the court. So it could be said that in this this our law is ultimately libertarian. Have whatever you want, do whatever you want, just don't commit crimes. And if you do, don't complain. Let's come to the firearm law. Our firearm law is said to be very strict by some, perhaps most strict in the world. And other people claim that it's very liberal, perhaps most in the world. So which of it is true? It can't be both true, right? No, it can't. Every firearms law consists of several aspects which can be strict or liberal independently from each other. So Czech firearms law actually has some very strict conditions. For example, we have diligent background checks. Not only criminal history is checked, but also some misdemeanors like brawling, interpersonal conflicts, and so on. We also have medical assessment of people who apply for firearms license, and it's not just medical assessment from your general practitioner, but he also can demand on his own a diagnosis from any specialist he wants. We also have competence exam. Before you apply for firearms license, you have to learn actually firearms law, you have to learn first aid, and you have to, of course, learn also safe handling of weapons and some basic of shootings. And this everything is actually examined in shooting range. First, you must pass standardized test of knowledge. And then you have actually to come to the shooting range and to show that you can handle weapons safely. You know loading, unloading, shooting, and so on. On the other hand, when you actually have firearm license or when you pass with everything, the license is shall issue. Anybody who fulfills requirement of the law is legally entitled to get firearms license. Not like in many countries, you pass the requirements of the law and then cops decide whether you shall or should not get license, whether you should or should not have a gun. No, in our country, cops have no discretionary power. You fulfill the conditions of the law, you can't get the license. The permit for concealed carry for self-defense is also a shall issue for anybody who fulfills conditions of the law. And there are no additional requirements. Anybody who has license for self-defense has also a permit to concealed carry. It's integral part of it. And also, when you have license, there are very few restrictions on type of weapons you can have in this country. These of you who were on shooting range yesterday, you shoot Czech assault rifle in semi-automatic versions. Very few weapons are actually prohibited. And even for prohibited weapons, you can get special permission, which is about the only thing in our firearms law where cops have discretionary power. Let's see some numbers to see how widespread firearms ownership is in our country. It's actually not very widespread, at least compared to, for example, Scandinavian or Baltic states. We have about 300,000 people who have firearms license. This number is quite stable over years. This is about 3.5% of adult population. But as you can see, there is a big difference from other countries. Almost 80% of people who have firearms license has permission for self-defense and for concealed carry. That's quite unlike any other European country. As you can see, sport shooting and hunting is a popular reason for owning license as well. And the numbers don't add up to 200%, because many people have multiple licenses. This is also a reason why so many people have self-defense license, because when requirements are very similar for different categories, people who apply for some special purpose, they want to hunt or they want to collect weapons, they usually apply for self-defense license as well, just for a case it might come handy.
Can I ask a question? We are talking about self-defense, and if somebody is threatening you with a gun and you have a gun in your belt or in your pocket, can you shoot him, or he has to shoot first?
No, definitely. Actually, self-defense is not covered by firearms law, it's covered by penal law. And I don't know whether I can translate it properly now. It says that self-defense is when you defend yourself against actual or imminent attack, and the defense can't be obviously inappropriate to means of attack. So when somebody pulls the gun with quite obvious intent to shoot you, yes, you can definitely defend yourself with gun. Types of license, yeah. Number of firearms is about 800,000. And this number is not stable, it steadily grows, because new weapons are manufactured and sold and so on. So a civilian arsenal in this country steadily grows. About type of these weapons. Category A, which is prohibited weapons, mostly automatic, there's about 1,200 of them in civilian possession. Mostly these are historic originals, like for example machine gun on the submachine gun from Second World War. These are mostly in possession of collectors. Category B are, I will describe it as defense and combat weapons, mostly handguns and semi-automatic rifles. This is also where we differ from other countries, because this kind of weapons is quite scarce in most other countries. While here, as you can see, it's almost half of civilian possession. Category C, firearms most common in other countries, hunting and sporting rifles are the rest. And we also have category D in our firearms law, which are air guns, black powder weapons, paintball guns, and so on. We don't know how many weapons of these are among the people, because these firearms don't require license nor registration, so they are not counted. But for sure, there's at least a million of them.
One question to the hunting rifles. So how are they defined in the Czech Republic? So if you use a semi-automatic rifle for hunting, so would it be a hunting rifle, or would it still be category B, or how?
It doesn't have to be category C. Semi-automatic rifles for hunting are also permitted, but there is a conflict between firearms law and hunting law, where firearms law states that hunting weapon is a weapon that's meant for hunting. And hunting law states that for hunt you can use only hunting weapon. So nowhere is actually defined what's hunting weapon. Generally it's like a basic rule. If there is no law, there is no restriction. it has to be long weapon. Means rifle, not handgun. As you can see, that our firearms law works pretty well. In 2014, there was 160 homicides total in this country, and only six of them were with legal firearms. Also, if you can see, almost half of homicides in this country were committed with improvised weapon, anything what was at hand in the moment, and another third was committed without any weapon at all. So almost 80% of murders in this country were committed with means that which by definition can't be regulated at all. So how this everything came to be? There are quite specific historic conditions in this country from this Firearm Act was born. And first of them is totalitarian history. Nothing teaches you a value of freedom like living few decades without it. I got 15 years in communism, I got enough. And it also created informal social consensus in this country that hiding guns from state is nothing wrong. You probably can't read Czech, but this is an edict from Nazi occupation of this country, which says that illegal possession of firearms is punishable by death. Even under threat of such penalty, many people didn't give up their guns, they hid them, And when the occupation came to its end, they came very handy. Also, in communist times, we could have firearms. We could have sporting firearms like 22s, if the citizen was member of shooting club that was approved by the state. We also could have hunting weapons if the citizen was member of the only hunting association approved by the state. And even when he was member of this association, he had no legal right to get the weapons. The police had discretionary power. If the policeman didn't like you for some reason, he said no, and that was it. The next factor that contributed to our firearms law was long line of weak governments, which we had now in 25 years of freedom. You perhaps know the quote of Ronald Reagan, when the government grows, liberty shrinks. Fortunately, it works another way around as well. These are results of our last elections. You may remember that only 3.5% of people in this country are firearms owners. But also, as you can see, the difference between third and second party was less than 2%. And there is also a threshold for entrance into our parliament, which is at 5%. And you can see that some parties barely crawled over it. Under conditions like this, no party can afford to piss off 3.5% of voters, especially if it's active and organized voters. On the other hand, you may know that last year in Scotland, the government licensed an air guns, which sounds totally crazy to me. I had my air gun when I was 12, without any license, without any permit, and it was in communist times. So, but when you look at Scottish Parliament, you see that the ruling party, Scottish National Party, can safely and comfortably piss off a few percent of voters and still be at charge. So the second rule is weak government is good for individual rights. The third factor is that there is no serious anti-gun lobby here. You may know, you who are interested in firearms laws, that American National Rifle Association is quite extreme organization today. But in the 60s, National Rifle Association actually supported some forms of gun control, especially ban for firearms possession for criminals. So what changed? In the 90s, serious and widespread anti-gun lobby was developed in the United States, and it was like crazy anti-gunners who would like to ban everything and call it common sense gun law. So naturally, National Rifle Association has to push into another extreme, otherwise they would lose. This didn't happen in this country. I think it's because legal firearms and firearms in general were never a big security issue. You saw our homicide rates and how small parts of it are firearms. So people quite don't care about firearms. They don't fear them. And when we have no opposition here, we can afford to be reasonable. We can afford to accept some limitations which are reasonable even in our view. For example, ban on carrying weapon while drinking. And that contributes a lot to stability of the law. And the fourth factor is that our firearms law is not created like firearms law in other countries. Like the government decides what the law is, the citizens are just supposed to obey, the police enforces it, and anybody who doesn't obey is punished. In our country, when the communist regime fell here, we had quite an argument how the firearms law should look like. And it was quite heated political argument, but in the end, we met with representative of state, especially administrative, and they told us, you know, we don't actually have problem with you having guns. Okay, we don't even care how many guns you have, that's your business. We don't even care what kind of firearms it is, as long as it's not machine guns and bazookas and so on. And we don't even actually care what you use it for, as long as it's not criminality. But we need two things. First, we need some security screening. We need to exclude from firearms ownership people like repeat offenders, violent criminals, psychopaths, alcoholics, drug addicts, and so on. People which are provably risk persons. And second, we need these weapons to be traceable. Because if they won't be, they shall escape to the black market, exactly to the kind of people which we want them to have. And we said like, okay, that's reasonable, but we have also some conditions. At first, it has to be right. No explain to the cop why you need the gun. No proving that you need the gun. No police discretion where cop shall decide in his own opinion whether you deserve the gun or you don't. No, it must be the right. Set in the law, anybody who fulfills the conditions has right, period. So I said this a few seconds before, it was that no discretion. Then there must be due process. If there are to be some conditions that applicant must fulfill, then the state must prove that these conditions weren't met. Not that citizen shall prove his eligibility. The state must prove that the citizen is ineligible if his rights are to be restricted. And at last, these conditions must be minimal. We understand that some conditions are necessary for security of the society, but we accept only conditions which are necessary. And of course, these conditions must be set at the level where the firearms license is available without much problems to common citizens. And the state said, well, okay, that's reasonable as well. And in this way, we came to this basic contract that basically is fine for everyone. And this contract in years was cemented by society, which approves it. When you stop any person on the street and ask what he thinks about firearms law, whether it should be more strict, or it should be more lenient, most likely answer you shall get is, it works pretty fine, don't mess with it. So Basic question: whether this system is applicable in other country, in other countries as well. No, at least not that directly. As I've shown, the firearms law in Czech Republic came from certain historic background and from certain specific conditions. And to apply this system in another country, these conditions would have to be met. For example, these conditions are clean start. When the communist regime fell, then basically all laws became illegitimate. We had to build our legal system anew. And firearm laws basically didn't exist. It was divided between hunting law and some other laws. So we basically started with blank slate. The second is peaceful past. As you could see, firearm crime is very rare in this country. We had a mass shooting 2 years ago, but it was pretty much the only mass shooting ever in this country. And murders with firearms in this country are 5, 3, 6 in similar rates per year. Also, there's a citizens' activity. Our Western colleagues often ask us how it comes that you have so much influence in this country. You have shall issue, you have shall issue permit. This year the government proposed actually a constitutional amendment to put firearms rights into constitution. Well, we started with it 20 years ago. And we work on it for 20 years. So we got this much experience, we have this much contacts, and it's a result of citizens' activities. Also, there was that long line of weak governments. As I said, when the government is weak, where elections are won by few persons, 3.5% of organized voters is something no party can ignore. And also there is a mutual trust with state in this country. Ask American what he thinks about his government, I mean conservative American, and he shall say something like, we can't afford registration in our country because our government would use it to confiscate our weapons. In this country, weapons are registered and the government never tried to confiscate it, probably because they know that we would hide them again. But also to show what kind of trust we among us at state is, last year, firearms law was changed, and one change was for long years there was a specific government power in our firearms law that in wartime or a state of national emergency, the government has right to confiscate legal weapons. This special government power was repelled last year. And it was repelled on government's own proposal. It was proposed by Prime Minister and Minister of Interior with explanation that democratic government that derives its authority from consent of the people doesn't need such power. So yes, with right kind of people, it actually can happen that government limits its own power. Okay, this will be about everything. Questions? Yeah?
Yeah, in order to guarantee the current state,
yeah, so
each and every citizen has a right to possess a weapon. And of course, it will be against the proposal of the European Commission, who is going to limit it, the private right to almost to the 0 point. So, what do you think is possible this year that this law will be passed by Czech Parliament?
About this constitutional change, it depends on which party shall on a position on of every party. The Minister of Interior is from strongest party in this country, but the second strongest party is against it. As you could see, there's no much difference between it. So last year, our parliament voted for a resolution that they disagree with limitations on firearms which are proposed by European Union, and 142 deputies out of 200 voted for it. So it will be safely a constitutional majority, but whether this majority shall hold or whether some deputies shall wessel out, we will see. That's more specific, single shot or double shot black powder weapons belong to the category D, revolvers and similar belong to the category C, but if it's just a muzzle loader rifle that used for example, reenactment and so on, which is loaded like that's without license, that's without registration. There is only a requirement that shooting with this weapon is allowed only on shooting range, because it's quite dangerous. Rest weapons of category D, like crossbows and air guns and similar, can be shooted pretty much anywhere where you don't endanger somebody.
What would be your biggest tips to enhance gun culture in other countries as well in Europe?
Yeah, so sorry.
What would be your biggest tip to also have a more or less a gun culture in other countries in Europe?
Comparison?
Yeah, compared to the Czech Republic.
This is. I actually thought to what I would compare our firearms law. Because it's not like American, it's not like Swiss, it's not like German, thanks God it's not like English. And it's quite unique, and I think it's most close to the Swiss. And we actually are in contact with Swiss, sharing information, because in Switzerland the gun culture is based on community defense. You know, they have their military rifles in their homes. When we came to the Switzerland, the man we were accommodated in his house, we came to the living room, one machine gun in the tripod, second machine gun on the tripod. We were like, what? He said, be like in home, just if you would find a weapon, it's loaded and it's real, like in home. But they have very strict conditions, for example, for concealed carry. They have it may issue. The cops decide whether they shall give them permit for concealed carry or not, and the default answer is not. And we in Czech Republic, our gun culture is strongly rooted in individual rights. The very base of our gun culture is right to freedom and right to self-defense. It's right of individual. And this is what we share with Swiss experience and know-how, because we want in this country to establish what they have, to extend this right to the community defense and to participation of citizens on defense on the of the state. And převzít něco do našeho zákona. Yeah. They need our experience with this individual right, because that's what they want. They want shall issue license, they want shall issue carry, they want, besides the community right, to establish an individual right to have a gun. For ordinary person, only concealed carry is permitted, because it's not. I don't know how to say it. The common public isn't used of seeing gun. Yeah, so you have to carry concealed to not scare people. Open carry is allowed only for municipal police. They don't count as policemen. They are count as security company hired by city. So they are civilians. They have civilian firearms licenses. And only other group of firearm owners which are permitted to carry openly are hunters, but naturally they are allowed to carry openly loaded weapon only on their hunting grounds. They can transport the weapon openly without container, but it has to be unloaded.
Hmm?
Yeah, but the Czech Republic already knew about the new EU. Yeah, sorry, I don't understand. Again, please.
Yeah, what is the Czech government doing about the new EU firearms directive, like, for example, the change of semi-automatic rifles?
Yeah.
10 round maximum, will there be changes for Czech citizens?
We fight it with tooth and nail. This is exactly what we got rid of 25 years ago. We had, when you listen to these arguments from various countries, you can see exactly where the Iron Curtain went. Arguments from the West are like, well, who needs such weapon? What do you need it for? It's nobody needs it. And the arguments from Eastern Europe was like, what? This is what we get rid 25 years ago. We lived 40 years under government that decide for us what we need, what we don't need, what we should have, what we shouldn't have. They directed our lives, and we got rid of it. And now we have 25 years a system where every citizen decides for himself what he needs and what he doesn't, what he doesn't need. And we very prize this, because we were made to live for a long time without it. It's part of our freedom. And the West doesn't understand it. I can tell you, when I talked with people from our Ministry of Interior who led the negotiations in the European Council. There was an original proposal to ban deactivated weapons, which are also without registration in our country. They are deactivated very diligently, so they are totally irreparable. And our representative said, but even if these weapons will be banned, it will be unenforceable. These weapons are not registered. We can't confiscate it anyway. And the Westerners said, so ban it in the law. But it won't work. So just write into the law that until date this or this, everybody must give us this weapon and bring it to the police. But our people won't do it. What do you mean won't do it? They won't obey. What? These people couldn't understand that it's possible that the government writes something into the law and the people say it's bullshit, we won't do it. And naturally for us Eastern Europeans, it's quite natural way of thinking because this is how we get rid of communists 25 years ago. So we learned this rebellious nature in the hard way.
If you could briefly describe what changes with the EU Firearms Directive, because I only skimmed through and I know there's a limitation to the magazines, you need to show good cause.
The good cause is already in the Firearms Directive, only Czechs translated it in their own way. The Firearms Directive says that the citizen has to have good cause for weapons possession. And so the Czech Firearms Law is based on the assumption then since what's not prohibited is permitted, that every reason that is legal is good enough. What? So the changes in the Firearms Directive, which was approved in the European Parliament a few days ago, mostly there are two areas of changes. Some weapons are banned. These are weapons which were formerly military and decommissioned into civilian possession, mostly by removing automatic function. So the automatic military weapon became ordinary semi-automatic rifle. Then there is a limitation of magazines. For long weapons, I mean rifles, the limit is 10 rounds. For short weapons, pistols and so on, the limit is 20 rounds. And also weapons which have folding stock or telescopic stock should be banned. We inquired for what reason, and we were told that French police thinks it's good. The other area of restrictions is that certain weapons which up to now were without registration are subject to registration, especially black powder weapons, replicas of historic weapons, and the third it was alarm weapons. So also these are weapons which are mostly harmless, or in case of black powder weapons, too slow to commit some serious crime with it. So there is no actual reason to register these weapons, and it will be only more problems for citizens, more work for police.